like a problem, continuous beam problem. We are dealing with only indeterminate structure. Already you know what is indeterminate structure means. So this is a continuous beam which is indeterminate. So that I don't want to go into the detail of that indeterminacy and all. So first step in solving the problem, identify the unknown displacements, as I told you. Here, in this particular beam structure, there are two members, AB, one member, BC, another member. In this, for the member AB, A is left hand, B is right hand. For BC, B is left hand, C is right hand. So this is general coordinate axis system we consider, positive direction, whether it is displacement or forces. Always we consider force or displacement, horizontal direction, positive, vertical direction, force or displacement, positive, rotation about this axis, clockwise, positive, anti-clockwise, negative. This is the general sign convention we follow. Now in these two members, here, A member, A joint, it is fixed. As I told you, when a given joint is fixed, there won't be any displacement. Displacement, mind it, not force. I am talking about displacements only. Since it is fixed end, at a fixed end, there cannot be any displacement. So here, there are, I told you, two types of displacement. One is vertical, another rotation. Because this horizontal displacement, we take it as zero because the member is assumed to be axially rigid. This vertical displacement is not possible here at fixed end. Rotation also is not possible, it is fixed. So theta A is zero, YA is also zero. When you come to this B, theta B, it is possible because this is just a simply supported end. So at simply supported end, member can rotate like that. So theta B is possible. I have kept it as theta B. And YB, that is not possible because it is propped here. So it is a support. If it is allowed to move, there is no question of keep use of this particular support prop. Prop means it makes the member to rest there at that particular point. It holds that. So that means YB is zero. There won't be any displacement there. But theta B, it is possible. Similarly, when you come to C, as it is happening in B, rotation is possible, translation is not possible. So known displacements are theta B, theta C, theta A is zero, YA is zero, YB zero, YC zero. When all translations are zero, delta is zero, that means it is called non-sway type of frame. All beams you can take it as non-sway because there won't be any vertical displacement, only rotations. Now these are the unknown displacement. So this is the very first step you have to do, the fundamental, which we call it as the kinematic indeterminacy. Already it has been told to you, the kinematic indeterminacy. First you have to determine kinematic indeterminacy for the given problem. So here kinematic indeterminacy, which we define as unknown joint displacement. Unknown joint displacement, as I told you now here, are only theta B, theta C. Theta A is zero, and YA, YB, YC are also zero. And all X displacement, that's also zero because all members we assume to be axially rigid. So only possible displacements are theta B, theta C. Now, second step. So this is a very important step. In this step, if you fail to identify the unknown displacement, your entire solution, what you could do further, it goes as a waste. Because this you have to identify correctly. Then only your problem will be perfect. Otherwise, if you don't identify this properly, then the entire part will go as a waste. So be careful in the very first step, kinematic indeterminacy. that is unknown displacement, you have to determine correctly, as I told you in the beginning, possible unknown displacement for each member, two translations and one rotation. Out of that one translation we neglect, only one translation, one rotation at each end. So that whether it is possible or not, you identify in the beginning itself, that is nothing but kinematic indeterminacy. That you have to do first step. Second step, you have to write slope deflection equation for each member. So I told you for each member, there will be two equations. Here there are two members, AB, BC. So there will be four equations. Two equations for AB, two equations for BC. You write that. So M for AB, for member AB, MAB. What is the equation I have given? MAB is 2EA by L. 2 into EA. EA of the member given is EA itself. You write that 2EA of AB divided by L. L is the length of the member. It is given as 6 into 2 theta A. That is twice rotation at left hand. The theta A is 0. So that is 0 plus theta B. Of course, that theta B is possible rotation at the other end. Then delta. There is no translation at all. Y A is 0, Y B 0, delta is 0. So that minus 3 delta by L is also 0. Then MAB bar, that is fixed end moment. Member AB, you fixed, and due to the given loading, whatever fixed end moments you are going to get, you have to calculate. So this is a standard thing which you have already studied in the previous structural analysis one class. So for UDL, the fixed end moment developed will be given by WL squared by 12, where W is the UDL given, which is nothing but 50 here. L is the span, that is 6 squared by 12, that is 150. So because the applied moment, due to the load, applied moment will be clockwise, resisting will be anti-clockwise. So this is anti-clockwise. As per our notation, it is negative. Right? And here, applied moment is like this, due to the load about this end, you will get a moment like that. Applied moment resisting will be opposite to that, that is like this. So this is clockwise only, which is positive, that is also WL squared by 12 only. So this was also 150. So MAB bar, it is minus 150, because it is anti-clockwise. Here it is clockwise. So then, or this you can write it as EI by 3 into theta B minus 150. You call this as equation 1. Next you write other equation, that is MBA, which is again similar to this. 2EA by 6, because it is same member, same EI, same length, and here this will be theta A.
Yes.
Right? So theta A is 0. This will be 2 theta B. Again, delta 0. And MBA bar, it is plus 150. So this is nothing but 2EI by 3 into theta B plus 150. So this is your second equation. So for one member, I wrote the slope deflection equation, which relates the moment at the ends in terms of displacement, possible displacement which are occurring. Then you write for other member on same lines, MBC, it is again 2EI by L, 2 into
2EI.
A is 2EI here, right? So it is 2 into 2EI divided by L is
8
into 2 theta B. 2 theta B plus
theta C.
And delta is again
0.
Then MBC bar, that also you have to remember, it is a standard case. So here you have concentrated load 80 kilonewtons, and this is 4 meters. Here on similar lines, the moment developed will be given by WL by N. Here it is WL square by 12, here it is WL by 8 on either side, because load is symmetric, moment developed at the 2A N's also same. Here also it is symmetric, moment developed is same. This is WL by 8, of course it is negative, so this is minus 80 into 8 divided by 8, that is 80, minus 80, here it is
plus 80.
Plus 80. That's fixed end moment. So that you have to take MBC is
minus
80. So the equation, if you simplify, you will get this 4EI, this is 4EI by L, or it is EI by 2 into theta B. Then 4EI by 8 into theta C, that is, oh, this is
EI into theta.
EI, yes. EI theta B. This is EI by 2 into theta C. And minus 80. This is first equation for the member BC. So similarly, for the other member of our MCB, other hand, if you write it, you will get this 4EI by 8. This doesn't change. This will be theta B, this will be 2 theta C, and this will be 0, this will be plus 80. So this equation will be EI by 2 theta B plus EI by EI theta C plus 80. So this is fourth equation. So this is second step. Whatever the slope deflection equations which just now I derived, that equations you have to write for all the members. Here there are two members, you have to write for those two members. This is for AB, this is for BC. For the two members, the two slope deflection equations, you have to write. After writing this you have to write correctly without any mistake. Right? There is nothing much here, only knowing the slope deflection equation, general expression, identifying the displacement at ends of each member, you can develop this equation. And once this is done, next you have to apply what is known as equilibrium condition. That means during the analysis always we assume structure to be stable. Stable means equilibrium. Right? It is stationary. It is not allowed to displace, undergo any displacement at all. So structure and not undergoing displacement means joints not undergoing any displacement. So that means that equilibrium condition we have to apply at the joints of the structure. So when there is no displacement, there should not be any force. Because without force, you cannot get any displacement. So in other words, instead of telling displacement is zero, we say the force developed, or what some of the forces developed, the net force developed at each joint should be zero. That is the equilibrium condition that we have to apply now. So that is third step. We say equilibrium condition, conditions. So we go on applying these equilibrium conditions at each joint, because now this is non-safe frame, only we apply equilibrium condition with respect to only rotations, not translation, because it is non-sway, only rotations. Rotation means movement. So that means the force has to be zero, sum of the forces has to be zero at each joint. So at joint A is fixed, there won't be any displacement, so there is no condition at all, because it is displacement is already zero, no condition. Next, joint B. This equilibrium condition we apply joint by joint. I told you structure should be stable or stationary. That means structure should be stable means joint should not undergo any displacement. I told you. So here this joint already it is fixed. There is no displacement happening at all. So there is no condition developed. So a joint B. So here displacement is possible, rotation is possible. Due to that rotation, forces are developed. That is, forces developed due to that rotation are the moments. So the moments developed are MBA and MBC. That moment developed, MBA plus MBC, must be zero for equilibrium. So at A, no condition. At B, you have MBA plus MBC, zero. This is the equilibrium condition. Next, go to the next joint, joint C. There should not be any displacement, right? So, but displacement is possible there, rotation. Because of that, MCB is going to develop. That MCB has to be zero, because it has to be in equilibrium condition. So at C, MCB has to be zero. This is the equilibrium condition. Is it clear? It is very, very simple. Equilibrium condition means structure should be stable. Structure should be stable means there should not be any displacement in the structure. The displacements we are considering only at the joints of the structure. So go on examining each joint, whether displacements are occurring or not. If at all it is occurring, due to that, what is the force developed? You find out that force, you make it zero in order to achieve equilibrium. So at A, as it is, no displacement, so no condition. At B, displacement is occurring, because of that, forces are developed, MBA and MBC. So that sum should be zero. Similarly, at C, force is developed because displacement is occurring, so that MCB has to be zero. Right?
Yes.
So here, one check is there. Here, as many equations you should get as there are unknown displacements to be determined. Because this we are getting by making displacement zero. Right? So that means this will help us in evaluating those displacement, because this is the equation. Forces we are making zero, we are getting the equation. So here there are two unknowns. Here we should get two equations. If you had that sway, you would have got one more equilibrium condition. That's called sway condition. So that will let us not bother. For beam problems, you don't have to bother. So that is your third step. Then fourth step, you have to evaluate that unknown displacement. So you plug this and this. Right? So here you have MBA, here you have MBC, right? In terms of unknown displacements. So MBA plus MBC has to be zero. These two equations you add it, you will get one equation. In terms of theta B, theta C, unknown displacement. Then MCB is zero, this is zero. You will get one more equation in terms of theta B and theta C. So you get simultaneous equations with unknown theta b and theta c. You have to solve those equations. You will get theta b and theta c. Come back, substitute in this, you will get unknown member forces. That's all I told you, analysis. So it is very, very simple thing, simple, straightforward, all on the fundamentals, no extra thing involved, only forces, displacements. Whether it occurs or not, that we are taking. The first step is, we say, formation of equations or simultaneous equations. We can call it, right? Euclid, second step and third step. We can say, from this MBA, MBC, that is 2, 3, from 2, 3, and 5. 2, 3, and 5. MBA plus MBC. These two you have to add. That means here 2A by 3, theta B, plus EI, theta B. If you add that, you will get 5 EI by 3 theta B, correct?
Yes. Just
check. These two, if you add it, you will get 3 LCM, 2 EI, 3 EI, 5 EI by 3 theta B. Then EI by 2 theta C plus EI by 2 theta C. Then 150 minus 80, that is 70. Correct?
Yes.
Or you can write this as, shall I multiply this by 6 by EI? Because I will take the LCM here, 6,
yes,
divided by EI. I want to make it whole figure.
Yes.
So if I multiply this by 6 by EI, I will get here 10 theta B. Then check once. 5 EI by 3 into 6 by EI, you will get 10. EI get cancelled. 6 by 3 is 2, 2 into 5, 10. Then EI by 2 into 6 by EI. So this will be 3. Theta C, and of course this is equal to zero. So this here, this I will transfer to the other side, so that is minus 70 into 6 by L, that is 420 by L. This is 7th equation. So I told you, I will get a simultaneous equation. So 10x plus 3y in that form. Instead of x, y, I will get theta b, theta c. First equation in terms of unknown displacement. Similarly, you club this. MCB equals 0, that is 4. MCB is from 4. 4 and 6. You can say from 4 and 6, from 4 and 6, you will get this EI by 2, theta B, EI by 2, theta B, plus EI theta C, EI theta C, plus AT, plus AT equals 0, plus AT. Zero. This is what I will get if I club that equilibrium condition and these components involved in that equilibrium condition. Here LCM is 2, I will multiply by 2 by EI. I will get here theta B, here I will get 2 theta C. This if I transfer that side, I will get minus 160 by EI. So I have two equations now. One is 7, another 8. 10 theta b plus 3 theta c is equal to minus 420 by EI. Theta b plus 2 theta c equals 160 by EI. So this you have to solve. It's a simultaneous equation. Instead of x, y, z, you have theta b, theta c like that. So if you solve this 7 and 8, you will get theta b and theta c. Then once I know theta b, theta c, I have determined the unknown displacements. So I will substitute this, and after solving, substitute this unknown displacement in the slope deflection equation back in that step 2. I will get MAB, MBA, MBC, MC. They are the moments developed at the ends of the member. That's what it is required in the analysis. So, fifth step, solution of equations developed in the step 4. So we can say solve 7 and 8 to get theta b and theta c. So simultaneous equation. Then next step to find final moments developed. So we have determined the slope and deflection. That is slope only here, deflection is 0. And once I determine the slope, I will use the slope deflection equations. That is step 2. I will find the moments developed. So use slope and deflection equations, slope and deflection equations of step 2 to get moments. That is, you substitute this theta b, theta c, solve in those equations, you will get moments. That's the analysis. MAB, MBA, MBC, MCB, you have it. Mind it that MCB has to be 0, so that you just check finally. So this is how we solve any indeterminate structure beam by this slope deflection method. It is a simple, straightforward method.
So theta b minus 22.
Theta
b. Yes, here we are having simultaneous equations. This is step number 5. So we are having solution of equations. So the solutions are equation 7 and equation 8. These are two simultaneous equations. We have to solve these two simultaneous equations to get theta b and theta c. So while solving equation 7 and 8, we are getting theta b value as, this is the value of theta b,
minus 21.17
by EI, and theta c equals
minus 69.41
divided by EI. These are two unknowns, theta b and theta c, we are getting by solving equation 7 and equation 8. Now what we have got, whatever the value theta b and theta c, we have to substitute in slope deflection equations. These are the unknown rotations we got by solving equation 7 and 8. Now we have to substitute these two values in equation 1, 2, 3 and 4 to get final moments. So that is your step number 6. Find the final moments. So to get final moments, we have to use slope and deflection equations of step number 2. So we are getting MAB equals EI by 3 into theta b. Theta b value is minus 21.17 by EI minus 150. EI get cancels. If you just do 21.17 by 3 minus 150, how much?
Minus 157
kilonewton meter. Similarly, MBA, that is equation number 2/3 2/3 into EI into theta b. Theta b is -21.17 divided by EI plus 150. Yeah, it cancels. 2/3 of -21.17 plus 150.
135.89 kilonewton meter.
Similarly, MBC MBC equals EI into theta b plus EI by 2 into theta c minus 80. So EI into theta b, EI into theta b is -21.17 divided by EI plus EI by 2 into theta c. Theta c value is -69.41 divided by EI -80. Here also EI get cancels. EI get cancels. -21.17 -69.41 divided by 2 -80. Just sum all these three things, we are getting -135.89 kilonewton meter. So lastly, we are having MCB equals EI by 2 into theta b. Theta b value is -21.17 divided by EI plus EI into theta c. Theta c value is -69.41 divided by EI plus 80 equals, we just do these things, EI again cancels, here also cancels, -21.17 divided by 2, -69.41, do these two sums, we are getting nearly 69.21, we are getting 80, minus 80 plus 80, we are getting 0. So we know that at simple support the moment is always 0. So here also we are getting 0. So now we got final moments. The last step is plotting of bending moment diagram. The last step is bending moment diagram. BMD. That is step number 7. It's 50 kilonewton per meter, 6 meters span, 80 kilonewton, 4 meter. Now, first draw free bending moment diagram. Span AB is having UDL. So the variation is parabolic and the value is WL square by 8. W is 50, L square is 6 square, 36 by 8. 15 to 36 by 8.
225
kilonewton meter. Similarly, this span BC is having central point load, that is the nature is triangle, and the value is WL by 4, 80 into 8 by 4, 160 kilonewton meter. So this is the free BMD. Now we have to plot whatever we obtained in step number 6, final moment values. For MAB we are getting 157. For MAB we are getting 157. For MBA we are getting 135.89 plus 135.89. Here also BC we are getting -135.89. MCB we are getting 0. Now you just join it by straight line. Here 0. It's negative. positive, negative, positive. So just shade whenever the two areas are not merging. I get portion points. Just shade things. Here we what are the portion? Whatever shaded portion it requires T when you are computing design. Negative state as well as positive state. But it's an analysis. We just determine the moment values. Moment values. This is regarding the problem. This is BMD, bending moment diagram. So it's a full problem for 20 marks. So the very first step is determination of kinematic indeterminacy. The very next step is FEM. Afterwards, slope deflection equation. Afterwards, joint equilibrium condition. Next, we are getting simultaneous equations in joint equilibrium condition. We have to solve those simultaneous equations to get unknowns. Those unknowns are kinematic indeterminates. Once again, you substitute to slope deflection equation, you are getting final moments. Finally, we have to draw the bending moment diagram. So this is a brief step how to solve the problem using slope deflection method. I hope you are getting the steps, very basic steps how to solve the problems. Thank you.